A very good morning to all of you. Okay, let's start reading from page number 113 and let's know more. Hotmail was one of the popular email sites and it provided free online email services. It was founded in 1996 by Sabir Bhatia and Jack Smith. Later on, Hotmail was acquired by Microsoft in 1997 and it joined MSN Group of Services. However, Hotmail does not exist anymore and all the Hotmail accounts that was previously created have been transferred to Outlook.com. That means one can still use their existing hotmail.com address to access the email account. Using it, they can also send and receive the email messages. A strong password consists of at least 8 characters that are a combination of letters in both uppercase and lowercase, numbers and special symbols as allowed it. Password is sometimes called a passcode and it is a memorized secret, typically a string of characters used to confirm the identity of a user. Password does not need to be an actual word but a non-word, as non-word may be harder to guess and which is the desirable property of the password. You have to choose the password that is strong enough as it cannot be easily decrypted by the hacker. Let's know more. When you receive an attachment, your inbox summary line usually indicates this with a paper clip icon on the email on the right. For example, if you receive an email that contains an attachment with it, you can see the attachment with the help of a paper clip icon on the right. After opening the message, when you click on the attachments icon, the attachment will be opened. And attachment is a computer file sent along with an email message. One or more files can be attached to any email message and can be sent along with it to the recipients. Next topic is email and its features. Millions and millions of computers with internet access communicate with each other round the clock. Internet has transformed the entire world into a global village by providing numerous ways to interact and communicate. So nowadays millions of million computers are connected with the internet and provide the access to various internet services, and you can also communicate with one another using the communication websites, and it has transformed the entire globe into the global village by providing a numerous ways to interact and communicate while sitting at your own houses. One of the most popular ways of communicating is email, that is discussed in detail. One of the most popular way that people normally use to communicate with one another, with their friends, with colleagues, with family members is the email. Email stands for electronic mail. It is a facility on the internet to send and receive messages anywhere around the world in real time. It works like conventional correspondence, but it is instant and convenient. It is instant as one can easily send and receive messages to anybody around the world. And email is the method of exchanging messages between people using the electronic devices. Email entered limited use in 1960s, but users could only send emails to the users of same computer, and some early email systems required the author and the recipient to both be online simultaneously. If somebody want to communicate with their friend, then both the friends should be online simultaneously. ऐसा नहीं है one is online another is offline, so both have to be online to send the email to one another. Tom Linson is credited as the inventor of email in 1971, and email operates across computer networks, primarily the internet. Today, email systems are based on store and forward model. Email servers accept, forward, deliver, and store messages. Neither the user nor the computer nor their computers are required to be online simultaneously. So if you want to send message to your friend and he is offline, you can easily send message to him whenever he is free or whenever he is checking his account. He can read your message and reply back to you. So both the user and the sender need not to be online at the same time. They need to connect to a mail server to send or receive messages or download it. The best part of email is that a single mail can be sent to a number of persons at the same time. That means if you are organizing a party, a birthday party, and you want to call your friends, you can take an example of 15 friends you want to call. So the matter will be same, venue, place, time will be same, and you will write a single email and send it to your 15 friends at the same time. You do not need to type the message to all your 15 friends one by one, and it will took some time. But if you write a single message, single email, and forward it to more than 15 users at a time, it can saves time, and you can use that time to do some another productive work. We can attach photos, videos, or important data along with our message. So along with your message, you can also even share your photos, videos, or any important data you want to share with your friend, with your colleagues, and these extra files are called attachments. Advantages of email is emails are delivered extremely fast when compared to the traditional point that we are using to communicate. Emails can be sent 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, and it is cheap. Each email sent is effectively free. Email account. In order to use the email facility on the internet, first we have to create a personal email account. If you want to send the email to your friend, then firstly you need to create your own personal email account so that you can use it to send the message as well as receive the message. We have to select a username and provide a secret code password along with our particulars like name, address, date of birth, etc. When you create your email account, you need to fill in your basic requirement, that is name, your address, your date of birth, and then you have to select your username, that is your email address, and a secret code, that is your password. Password should be strong enough that so that it cannot be easily hacked by the unauthorized person. There are many websites on the internet which provide us with the facility of free email accounts. So there are so many sites of the internet using which we can create our email account and send email messages to one another easily. The popular sites are www.gmail.com, www.yahoo.co.in, and www.rediffmail.com. These are the sites. We need to create an email account on these sites, and then we can use that email account to send messages to our friends, family, colleagues, anybody we want to send the message or anybody we want to communicate. What is an email address? An email address consists of a username and a domain name. So email address is made up of two things. First is username and second is domain name. Username. Username is the name of the person's account by which this server identifies him on the website. So Username is the name of the person's account. Person sender who want to send the message. His account name is the username by which server identifies him on the website. That means your email address, your name will be used as your identification on the website. And username is the name of a person's account by which the server identifies him. And domain name is a unique name that identifies a website on the web. Domain name is address where internet users can access your website. It is used for finding and identifying computers on the internet. Whenever we create an email account, we get an email address on which people send their mails. When we create our email account, then we will be provided with the email address using which we can send the mails to one another. An email address identifies the email box to which email messages are delivered. It is a unique identifier for an email account. It is used to both send and receive email messages over the internet. An email message requires an address for both the sender and the recipient in order to be sent successfully. Why we provide the use the domain name? As every computer that is connected to internet is provided with an IP address, and it is very difficult for the user to identify and to remember that IP address in order to connect to that particular computer. So to ease the user, to provide the flexibility for the user, domain name is created so that user need not to remember the IP address of the computer. They can only use the unique name that identifies the website on the web. Send their mails. Every email account is associated with a unique email address, which means that no two individuals in the world can have the same email address. So every email account is associated with unique email address. Jo bhi email account create ho raha hai, uska jo email address hai, it will be unique. It will not be same to one another. If you are creating a new email account, sometimes you get a message that your name has already been registered. You have to choose the new name. That means if one name is registered with the email account, you cannot create a new email account using that same name. So every email account has a separate or a unique email address. Unique means it will not be same, and no two individuals can have the same email address. Jitne bhi you persons in email facility use kar rahe hain, un sabhi ka email address jo hai wo different hai. Koi bhi two persons ka email address same nahi hoga. As in your class, there are roll number provided to each student, and we identify you people with the help of your roll number, and no two students can have the same roll number in a class. The same way, if we are using an email facility, then no two individuals would have a same email address. And this is the example of email address: kipspublishingworld@gmail.com. This is the username. Username is the name of the person's account by which the server identifies him on the website. So this is the username using which server identifies him, that this is the person whose email has been sent, whose email has been received. And this is the @. Domain name is gmail.com. Unique name that identifies a website on the web. There are so many websites on which email account can be created, but this email account has been created on this domain, on this website, that is gmail.com. That's all for today, students. Thank you.